Hello, just a heads up, this tutorial uses the Excel mobile app. It's free, so if you don't have it, make sure to grab it from your app store. To begin importing your receipts, we'll open the Excel app on your phone or tablet, and then we'll press the plus sign to open up a blank workbook. Or if you already have a file that you'd like to import the receipt to, just make sure to select and open that. So at the bottom of this blank workbook, you'll see a small icon that looks like a sheet with tabs. Press that, and this will bring up icons for some popular features in Excel, along with an ellipsis for more items. So we'll press the ellipsis to bring up the Excel tabs. From this green dropdown, you can select which of Excel's tabs to go into. And for this example, we're going to select the Insert tab. And then once here, press Data from Picture. And this is going to open up a screen that's going to resemble a phone or a tablet's camera. And you can choose to import a picture of a receipt or other document, but I'm going to press the circle button to take a picture of a receipt that I want to import. So once you press the button, you'll get a screen where you can position your document. And then once you have it positioned how you want, press the circle to photograph the receipt. And then you'll want to press Review and Edit so that Excel can begin extracting its data. If you think that this tool is helpful, just wait until you try Connect Team's AI tools. So Connect Team, the sponsor of this video, is an employee management app built specifically for non-desk teams. And their AI tools are made for mobile, on-the-go use by any employee, even if they're not tech savvy. And everything works right inside the app, and it could save each user up to 10 hours every week. Similar to Excel, their AI tool can turn any paper form that you've uploaded into an editable digital form. But with Connect Team, you can also create an AI chat agent that will answer questions about your company's policies, manuals, or SOPs. It can also help you build employee training courses, automate shift scheduling, and so much more. It's super easy to use for both management and employees. And what's more, you can start for free. If you have 10 users or less, it's free to use. More than 10 users, you can get a 14-day free trial, no credit card needed. So make sure to scan the QR code on your screen or go to the link in the description of this video and open your free Connect Team account today. And thank you, Connect Team, for sponsoring this video and supporting this channel. After scanning, you're going to see a preview of what data was scanned. So here we'll press Insert to begin inserting the data. And during the scanning, Excel usually flags some items as potentially having an error. So in this screen, you can select to either import the file as is by pressing Open Anyway, and then make any edits directly on the sheet, or you can review and choose what edits, if any, to make to these items before importing. So for this example, we'll walk through a few of these to give you an idea of what this process looks like. So I'll press to review. So one issue with the way this receipt is formatted is that the zeros all have a dot in the middle of them, and Excel doesn't quite know what to do with that. So I have this line that's really just gibberish. So I'm just going to use my backspace key to delete this entire line. And then once I'm done with deleting them, I'll press Done to move on to the next item. So the issue with this next item is the way the comma, space, and abbreviation for Florida are formatted. And for my needs, this isn't an issue, so I'm just going to press Ignore so I can skip it and move on to the next item. So the next item is a blank space where Excel inserted some code, and I'm just going to, again, use the backspace key to delete that and then press Done to move on to the next item. So the next issue, again, has to do with the zeros that have the dot in the middle. Excel just can't read those. So I'm going to fix the date so that it reads correctly. And then the numbers to the right of the date, I'm just going to delete those. I don't need them. So as you can see, it's really a judgment call of how you want to either correct or keep a flagged item as is. But keep in mind, once you finish importing your scanned document and save it, you can edit it the same way as any other spreadsheet. Once you're done, your data is going to be converted into a table and imported into your Excel sheet. And when you're ready, click the back arrow found here on the top left of your screen to exit the document, and you'll be prompted to save your file. Thanks for watching, and for more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.